The first time I published an ad with code instead of manually in the Ads Manager, I knew I had suddenly opened up a whole new world of experimentation. Even if you don't know how to code, anyone who wants to get to an advanced level of Facebook ads should get comfortable exploring the API. The first thing you need is to create a developer account and a Facebook app, like I've done here, which is showing up as Lado. If you follow the instructions, it should be relatively straightforward to set up, although we don't have time to cover it here. You need to make sure that you have at least ads read permissions, otherwise you won't be able to pull any data. Finally, click Generate an Access Code, and then Continue as You, and then you're going to get this access token. This is what you would use to actually make the calls, although right here it's actually baked in. This is kind of like your password if you were logging into Facebook normally. So let's make our first API call. You can see this is the endpoint we're calling here, and if we hit Submit, then it's going to give me back my name. So let's do something a little bit more useful. My ad account is up here. You can see in the URL, that's the ID. So I'm going to paste that across into the Graph API. And you can see that I get an error. That's because there's a common issue with this API. You need to actually add ACT underscore, so account, in front of the ID, and then it works. But I just have the ID, so that's not that useful. Let's see what else I can add. So if you click into fields here, you can see all the different things that are available for accounts. So I'm just going to add in the name. I think that's quite useful. And then the amount spent. So I can see how much I've spent total. If I hit enter, now I get that back. No, we didn't spend $7 million on ads. Actually, anytime you get a currency back from Facebook, it's in cents. So this is actually $77,000. Okay, once you're in an ad account, you can actually do a few more things. So I could get the campaigns that are in my account. If I copy there, I forward slash and then campaigns, you can see that campaigns are available. Within campaigns, I could also then get the name or the status, really whatever it is I need. Now let's get our ads. So I'm going to double click on campaigns and click ads, and then that's going to give me the name and status of all my different ads. A few things to know about these pages is one is if you click into any of these IDs, it'll actually take you to the endpoint for that ad. And then two, it actually returns just 25 results, and you actually have to click next to get to the next set of 25 results. Alternatively, if you scroll up, you could actually just put dot limit and then choose how many you'd like. You can have up to 5,000 return. I'm going to query a specific ad though, the one I was looking at earlier. So if I go into my account and I find an ad, I can click in the top right corner here and then click copy the ad ID. And I don't actually have to go into the individual accounts because everything has a unique ID. So I can just paste that here and there's my ad. If I put the name and the status, I can get that back as well. Now, one thing that's a little bit confusing with the way the Facebook API is set up is that an ad is not where all the creative assets sit. So you actually have to call for an ad creative instead. If we type in ad creatives, we can see which ad creatives are associated with this ad. And in most cases, it's just going to be one. You can see here, this is the ID for that ad creative. If I click on this, it's going to take me directly to it. Now I'm at the ad creative level. That's where I can pull the text and the images associated with the ad. So let's do that. Let me get the title of the ad. I want to get the body and then potentially the image URL as well. Let's hit enter. And there we go. We have our ad. To add further complication though, this isn't really where you would edit the ad either. Actually, you have to go one step further, which is to get the object story spec. So a little bit confusing, I know, but just bear with me. So if we type in object story spec, you can see that we actually have the full text of the ad now. So we have the link that it's going to, we have the page ID, the Instagram page ID, we have the message, we also have the name of the ad, the caption, and then the image hash as well. So whenever you upload an image to Facebook, it'll return an image hash, and that's what you would actually use to create a new ad. If it was a dynamic ad, it would be slightly different. This would be the asset feed spec, which you would put here, asset feed spec. But this isn't a dynamic ad, so it's going to use the object story spec. Now, if we wanted to make a change to this ad, we could. We would call this endpoint, we'd pull the object story spec, we would look through the text and make a change, and then we would send it back to Facebook. But instead of a get request, which pulls information, we would go to a post request, and this would update that ad. Alternatively, we could delete the IDs and then send this through and create it as a new ad. Now, there's obviously more information you would need to send Facebook in order to create a new ad, but that gives you the general idea of how this works. One thing I recommend is to go to the Marketing API reference, which is the URL here, and then scroll through and see what's available. They have some pretty great documentation on what endpoints are available, and when you call those endpoints, what fields you can pull. So for example, if I go into Ad Creative, and then I scroll down, it shows me a few options in different coding languages of how I would call this API, and then you can go into the individual field limits and see what parameters are available as well. So you can see thumbnail height, thumbnail width, the account ID, the asset feed spec we talked about earlier, as well as the body text, the call to action type, so which button you're using, and a number of other things. So pretty much everything that's available in Facebook is available in the API. Actually, more is available in the API than is available in Ads Manager. So it's really worth looking through this and seeing what's possible. Even if you don't code, you should feel comfortable reading this documentation because it allows you to play around and see what's available and potentially would spark your creativity of what you could automate with your Facebook ads.